In this video, I'll be discussing compound composition, determining both the mass percent and the mole ratio. Our objective is to analyze the composition of a compound to determine its mass percent and mole ratio of elements within that compound. The reason this is important is because it helps us, both mass percent and mole ratio, to get in between quantities we can measure in the laboratory in grams and what's occurring on the molecular level, the number of particles or objects. The mole is the connection between these two, the macroscopic and molecular levels, and it has already been discussed in previous videos. Let's first deduce the mole ratio from the molecular formula. What the mole ratio does is relates the moles of atoms within a compound to moles of molecules. Here's a molecule for us to look at first, ethanol. Here are four different representations. The last is the molecular formula, C2H6O. What we can deduce by looking at this molecule is that in every one molecule of ethanol, we have two carbon atoms, six hydrogen atoms, and one oxygen atom. Now, when we think about this on a mole quantity, which is generally helpful when converting between grams and number of molecules or atoms, when we have a mole of ethanol molecules, what that tells us is we have 6.022 times 10 to the 23rd ethanol molecules. What that means is that in a mole of ethanol molecules, we have 2 moles of carbon atoms, 6 moles of hydrogen atoms, and 1 mole of oxygen atoms. These are mole ratios and can be written individually as such. For every 1 mole of C2H6O, there are 2 moles of carbon atoms. For every 1 mole of C2H6O, there are 6 moles of hydrogen atoms. And for every 1 mole of C2H6O, there are 1 mole of oxygen atoms. Let's put this to practice and apply it to a stoichiometry problem. Here are several representations of the molecule benzene, which has the formula C6H6. We can determine that in every 1 molecule of benzene, there are 6 carbon atoms. Therefore, in every mole of benzene atoms, there are 6 moles of carbon atoms. Likewise, in every 1 mole of C6H6, there are 6 moles of hydrogen. Now, if you were asked how many moles of carbon are in 587 grams benzene, we can convert from grams of C6H6 to moles of C6H6, and this is something you should be familiar with from the ratio on the or the video on the mole concept earlier. And then from moles of C6H6, we now have the tools to get to moles of carbon. And that's exactly what's being asked for in this question. Now, the connection between moles of benzene and moles of carbon, that's the mole ratio. So working this problem, we'll start off with our 587 grams of benzene. We know the molar mass of benzene, or can calculate it, as 78.1 grams C6H6 per 1 mole of C6H6, and it becomes helpful at this point to indicate what substance you're talking about when you put moles, right? Because in this case, we want to calculate moles of carbon, but we don't want to confuse ourselves and be like, oh, there's 1 mole, we're done. We want to be sure we're getting to moles of carbon, not moles of benzene. Then the last conversion factor we're going to use is our mole ratio. We need moles of benzene on the bottom, and moles of carbon on the top. When we look at the units, grams of C6H6 cancels, moles of C6H6 cancels, and we're left with moles of carbon. When I calculated this, I got an answer of 45.1 moles of carbon specifically. And that's what we're looking for in this problem, moles of carbon. Double check on your calculator and see if you get the same thing. Mass percentage is a different way to classify the composition of a compound. How we'll calculate the mass percentage is by taking the mass of one of the elements in a mole of a compound and divide by the mass of one mole of the compound. This is also known as the molar mass, which I'll just write as mm, the molar mass. Once we calculate that ratio, we'll then multiply by 100. Let's look at carbon dioxide as an example. The formula for carbon dioxide is CO2. We can calculate the mass percentage of carbon and the mass percentage of oxygen, as these are the two elements of the compound. Let's start with carbon. To calculate the mass percentage of carbon, we'll need the mass of carbon in one mole of CO2 over the mass of one mole of CO2, multiplied by 100. The mass of carbon in one mole of CO2 can be found by looking at the periodic table. We know that we only have one mole of carbon atoms in a mole of CO2, and the molar mass of carbon is 12.01 grams. So our one carbon atom, so this is one carbon, times the molar mass of carbon, and then we'll divide that by, in the denominator, the mass of one mole of CO2, which is the molar mass of CO2. You can find that by adding together the mole of the molar mass of carbon plus 2 times the molar mass of oxygen. When we multiply by 100, I got a percentage of 27.29% carbon by mass. It's important to note here that all of the mass percentages of the elements in a compound should add to 100 because we're dealing with percentages here. So we could find the mass of oxygen by simply calculating 100 minus 27.29. However, I'm going to show you how to do it the long way, just in case you ever need to know. So let's then calculate the mass of oxygen. It's going to be very similar to our calculation with carbon, except now in the numerator we have the mass of oxygen in one mole of CO2. It's important to note here that we place a 2 within this expression, 2 times the mass of oxygen, because we have 2 oxygen atoms in the compound. 2 times 16 over the molar mass of carbon, 44.01 times 100. When I did this, I got 72.71% oxygen by mass. You should note that 72.71 plus 27.29, our carbon percentage by mass, add to 100. This is a good check for mass percentage problems. Let's take this information and apply it to a stoichiometry problem. What are mass percentages mean? For example, 27.29% carbon by mass. This means that in every 100 grams of CO2, there are 27.29 grams of carbon. This is the meaning of a mass percentage. Another way to convey this information is through a ratio. For every 100 grams of CO2, there are 27.29 grams of carbon. For oxygen, it's similar. 72.71% oxygen by mass means that for every 100 grams of CO2, there are 72.71 grams of oxygen. This can be conveyed by a similar ratio. If you were given the problem, how many grams of oxygen are in 35 kilograms of CO2, one way to solve this problem is by using the mass percentage. If you have 35 kilograms of CO2 to start, we'll first need to use our metric prefixes. 1 kilogram of CO2 on the bottom is equal to 1,000 grams of CO2. Then we have a conversion factor to get between grams of CO2 and grams of oxygen. And that's our mass percentage right here. On the bottom, we need to have the mass of CO2. Per 100 grams of CO2, there are 72.71 grams of oxygen. Kilograms CO2 cancels, grams of CO2 cancels, and we're left with grams of oxygen. When I did this calculation, I got 2.5 times 10 to the fourth grams of oxygen. Double check yourself and see if you get the same thing. The objective of this video was to give an example or give a few examples of how to analyze the composition of a compound to determine both mass percent and mole ratio of elements within that compound. Here are some practice problems that you can do on your own. For the first set, determine the mole ratio for all elements in the compound. For the second set, determine the mass percent for all elements in the compound. As an extra challenge, I would encourage you to create your own stoichiometry problem where you need to use either mole ratio or mass percent or both to find the final answer. Good luck, and I'll see you in the next video.